All right, so coffee exploring, episode 2 in Kansas City, and about ready to head off. Gotta keep it pretty quiet right now because the family's still sleeping. But the only hard part about going out to the city or leaving the house is leaving this guy. Kobe. Hey, buddy. You say hi? Hi. All right. See you, buddy. Be back. All right, watch out. So we're headed out to our first spot today, and the only spot. The only bad thing about right now is it's still gloomy. Like, if you can see outside. So, I don't know, maybe it's just like bad juju that that it's every Saturday that I'm doing this, that it's rainy and gloomy, which is fine. I mean, nothing bad about going to a coffee shop when, you know, it's cloudy, you kind of get the warm, cozy vibes inside, having the hot coffee when it's raining outside, I get that, but I'm more of a hot summer type of guy, and I like the sunshine, and it just gets me more upbeat, you know, but I'll have to just go with it. So I'm running a little late, so I'm going to have to meet Noah. Ooh, I don't know, we'll see if we can do this. I think I got some magic left in the tank. What's up, homie? Good to see you, dog. Good to see you, man. How you been, bro? Oh, that was nice, dude. That was super nice. All right, so where are we at today?
We're at Vested Coffee.
There we go. And this is your first time, right?
It's my first time I've never had.
All right, bro. Yeah, so this is the vibe of Vested right here. It is by the River Market, which is really cool. So, yeah, we're going to go ahead and go in. Let's do it. Twice or three times, and that's really, really good. But we'll see where we're going from today.
Hi guys, how's it going?
Hey.
We're good. That's awesome.
Actually, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Pretty good. You mind if you introduce yourself?
No, I'm fine.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Hey, I'm Susan. I'm the owner of Vested Coffee. Come see us. We're in the garment district.
There we go.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
How long has this been here? How long have you guys been here?
A year and a half.
Year and a half. Yeah. I remember I went here about right when it opened.
Yes.
You were like the nicest person welcoming me. And I was like, wow. And I was like, she works here. And then you said she was the owner.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, I've never had an owner like that, you know, that personal. So I would just, as far as like is welcoming and the vibe here, I would say it's a 10 out of 10. So
yeah.
For sure. Yeah.
Awesome.
Of course.
Awesome, yeah.
And as far as like, what drinks would you recommend? I mean, I know I've had the Onyx Delight. I think
yes.
That's what he's going to go for. What is the Onyx Delight? Because
yes.
I don't really know what it is.
Onyx Delight is by far our most popular latte. It is a combination of honey, cinnamon, and vanilla.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, it's
awesome.
It's
pretty
good.
Pretty
good. Ice.
Yeah.
Ooh, okay.
For
dang.
Our seasonal, what's been really popular for summer and spring has been the honey lavender.
Okay.
But then we are also introducing our pumpkin butternut spice.
Ooh.
You have the pumpkin butternut spice today?
Yeah.
Ooh.
We do.
You do that almond milk at all?
What?
You do that almond milk?
Yeah.
Okay. I will do the pumpkin with butternut spice
almond milk.
Dude, that's gonna, that sounds so amazing.
And you want that hot?
Would you recommend it hot?
Yeah, we'll do that hot today.
And then, I might come back with pastries. I still gotta look.
Yeah, I've been kind of like looking at them.
Am I gonna get coffee?
I am gonna get coffee, yeah.
What are you getting?
I think I am, man, yours sounds really good. Can I try yours?
You can try mine, yeah. You can try, I'll try yours, you try mine.
Alright, so super nice lady. Also, rule of thumb, when you're going to any coffee shops, especially like Third Waves, where they have, like, you know, like smaller businesses, always tip your barista. I think Noah can attest to that.
Let's put them on.
You take the mask off. What do you think about tipping your barista? Because as far as like, you probably hourly, you don't get as much sometimes, right?
It depends. I worked at a couple places. When I was getting like $9 an hour, it was nice to get a little bit of tips.
Yeah.
Because obviously I'm a college kid.
Yeah.
I pay for college at the same time. Like, pay bills and stuff like that. But like, tips do make a big difference, especially like at the end of the week where you're like, dang, like I need a little extra cash. Like,
there you go.
We got all that cash money.
Yeah,
like,
okay.
From tips.
Cash money, so, baby.
Yeah, for sure.
You're here. No, 101.
Yeah.
Oh, this is awesome, bro.
All
right.
Second.
A few moments later.
So, she got the coffees. Oh my gosh, man, smell that. It smells so good. That's a umami.
Bro.
Okay, so I got the pumpkin butternut spice, got it hot, and then Noah got the,
what's it called, the onyx,
onyx delight,
onyx delight,
which is like cinnamon, cold. Honey,
cinnamon, yeah, honey, and vanilla.
Wow, that's like, that's different, like the butternut, the pumpkin butternut, whatever, but it's really good.
Got to try it.
Yeah.
And you try this one.
Yeah, wow. So if you come here, it's seasonal, it's in the fall.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, so if you're a bitch,
really,
if you're a pig, pig.
If you're a pig.
If you're a pig, get it. No, if you're a big pumpkin fan, I would definitely highly recommend this. I think this is better than, no offense to Starbucks, but I think this is better than the Starbucks latte. So.
Yeah, Starbucks can't really compete.
Oh, yeah, this is.
You know, Starbucks burns their beans so that everything's like, same playing field. Like,
really?
They'll literally burn them in every location. Just so if one bean's better than the other, you can't like compare locations.
That's crazy.
They'll just burn all their beans. That's what I
mean. That's a smart idea.
Yeah.
But, so what would you rate that drink out of like 10?
I want to
as far as cold drinks, I mean, it's definitely unique.
It's great.
Never had
yeah.
it before.
I think it's really good. I think the shot's obviously different. And so like, I'll talk about the shot for a second. It's not a very like strong shot and like a fruity, like acidic shot, like some are.
Yeah.
It's a more like, what's the word for it? Like a chocolatey.
Smooth balance. Maybe.
Smooth,
yeah.
It's smoother. So it's like we talked about last video, like it's a low altitude.
Yeah.
But I like that. Like.
Yeah, Messenger's shots I feel like are really
yeah.
acidic. They're strong. They
They're
are.
Very high quality beans.
They are, yeah. And they do Onyx coffee here, which is really, I think it has some high quality coffee beans, Onyx. I think
oh, yeah.
They actually have, so if you're ever in Arkansas, they have one in the Onyx. Like, I think it's like the first one original, but it's huge. It's like almost like a Messenger here in Kansas City, but in Arkansas. So if you're ever in Arkansas, go check out Onyx. They have like two, three floors. I mean, they have like bar upstairs. It's pretty cool, man. We might have to make, take a road trip and just try Onyx.
Bro,
we might, instead of the KC season, we might have to go out and just try it.
So down. We can just take a weekend. I'm sold.
It's only like 3 hours away, so it'd be worth it to try.
One day.
Also, if you're watching this, like, comment, subscribe, help your boy out.
That was the first like on this video.
There you go. Yeah. Dream team, baby. But yeah, this is, if you're gonna come here, you can't go wrong with the Onyx Delight and the butternut, the pumpkin butternut. You can get them iced or hot. I just chose hot and you chose iced, so it's just a personal preference. But yeah, definitely a solid drink.
Yeah, for sure.
All right, so just got done with my coffee, obviously. I drank that in probably, what, like 2 minutes? You still have some left.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I'm holding back.
So now we're gonna go back and we're gonna hit some food. I told you last week at all the
Korean Chinese food. I think we're kind of out of time, but they have some really good Pop-Tarts, cinnamon rolls, apple fritters. They have some biscuits and gravy. And I think my man Noah might get a breakfast burrito. So we'll meet you there and get some food. Let's do it. Just take a glimpse of this stuff.
Oh yeah, nice. Man, I don't know.
Say cheese.
Dude, Pop-Tart looks good.
Cream cheese Danish looks heat.
It does look good.
It looks like homemade Pop-Tarts.
Pumpkin cream cheese muffin.
That does, yeah, that's it.
Dude, that looks fire. That blueberry scone, I think I'm gonna have to get it. Hey. I'm gonna have to get the blueberry scone, but if you guys are coming and you're a big pumpkin person, I would definitely get that thing. That thing looks amazing.
Yep.
Hey, come back and get me some food. Yeah. The pumpkin cream cheese thing looks so good, the cheese muffin, but. Oh, I can't make them on. Do you like blueberry scones?
They are
good. Okay. I will do a blueberry scone, and then I will. That would be awesome, actually. Tell them what you got, man.
First bite.
What is it though? Tell them.
I think it's a broccoli, cheddar, like egg, like bacon. Like quiche.
Little quiche. That's pretty good, dude.
Yeah, it's pretty.
You like it?
Yeah.
Also, it's gluten free, so. Yeah. So if you're gluten free. Alright guys, so I opted out instead of the pumpkin cream cheese thing, which looked honestly delicious. I'm a big blueberry guy. I like to say that I'm pretty fruity, so. But I got a scone, and then Susan, the owner, I mean, you can ask, I mean, Noah too, about you. I mean, she's super nice, outgoing. Say, hey, you want that warmed up? I'm like, yes, ma'am, I want that warmed up. She came in clutch for that. So, I mean, dude, look at that. That is fire. Steam coming out of it. Take a little bite here. That hits different, man. It's like almost like a mixture of like a scone and a muffin.
Mm-hmm.
So like one thing I don't like about scones a lot of times is they're like really dry or hard, like super, super hard. This is like hard on the outside and gooey on the inside. I got my chocolate chip cookies. Mm. Solid, I give this like 8 out of 10. Probably. That's my go-to, it's like 8 out of 10. I think they're good. So.
Yeah.
So if you are 20 and younger, I highly recommend you don't watch this. I'm drinking a shot right now, so just, sorry mom, this one's for you. I'm just joking, kids. It's a shot of espresso, nothing. It's not like tequila or anything like that, so. Wow.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's like in between, dude.
Can I try?
It has like a bitter aftertaste to it.
Yeah.
Which is like what it's gonna be. But it doesn't have a burnt taste, which I don't like for an espresso shot. So if you're a big espresso guy, I think it'd be really good. With a portato, macchiato. What else do they have? They have obviously lattes and mochas. They do have a cappuccino here. But yeah. It's not like messenger where it's like, man, once you take a shot, you need like sparkling water right after. But it definitely got a strong kick to it. I'll let the professional take a test of it and see what he thinks.
You'll be able to explain it better than me.
That's pretty good. So one of the big things they tell us when like testing coffee is like when you're opening a shot, you have to test the shot to see if it's good. And so how we test shots is like where it hits on the tongue. And so I'm kind of rusty on this, but I think when it's bitter, it hits the back of your tongue the hardest. And so it's definitely a bitter shot because like it'll stay on the back of your tongue for the longest amount of time. And also when it comes to like grinding beans and stuff, when it comes to like pulling a shot, like the fineness and also the like coarseness of the beans can also affect the bitterness and all those other things. So I'll stop right there. But go on forever.
There you go.
Jaywalking.
All right, just got back from Vested Coffee. We were all done. Amazing coffee, amazing pastries, even better owners. Susan and her husband were phenomenal. They were always like super outgoing, nice to us. I could even tell like when I was walking around, just talking with Noah, they were already like helping out other customers, and they were like, hey, we can try this or that. So I think it's also like pretty awesome to go in a coffee shop where they're very personable. It just makes you feel at home. So it's like, as far as ratings go, I think the vibe of it, it felt really like I was at home, honestly. So as far as studying place, solid. Like I would, there's a couple charging stations. There's a girl right by us. She was doing some, I think, probably schoolwork. Nice little table, seemed pretty comfortable. So I think as far as like if you want to study there, I'd say I give like a solid maybe 7 out of 10. The only thing, probably it's not super big, so you probably can't do like any like Zoom calls and stuff like that. You could be good for maybe a little small business meeting if you're in business. So that's a good option. As far as like a date review, so we're talking about, you know, if you want to take something special on a date. I mean, I'd say it's a pretty cool place because you have the river market, which is right across from that side. So, man, maybe grab some coffee, then go to the river market, grab some coffee here, whatever you like. You know, it's a pretty chill vibe. I think you have a nice little private conversation in Vested. As far as food and coffee goes, that was outstanding. I mean, they had specialties. And when you go to order on the menu, like, it's not overwhelming. Like, the only thing about, like, Starbucks and some of the places I've been to and Dunkin', like, I mean, they're decent, but they just have so many options to choose from that if you're not a big coffee person, you're trying something new, and you're kind of put on blast, you're walking in like, what do I want? Because I've been there. That is not like this in this case. That's just super simple. You have your basic espresso drinks, you have a couple specialties, and like right there in front of you as far as food cases. I mean, you saw it in the video, like, my mouth was watering. It was so good. Blueberry scone, phenomenal. Whatever Noah got, I think it was like some of the quiche thing he got, yep. It was pretty good. So I think next time we're come back, they said the biscuits and gravy are outstanding. I love me some biscuits and gravy. I know Noah does too. So I think if you're there next time and that's you want to try, definitely go for biscuits and gravy. But really overall, a really solid place to go to. It's definitely like home vibe, and I don't think you can really go wrong with it with being where it's at. So.
All right, man, we'll see each other maybe next week. We haven't really seen, we have to decide on a coffee shop, so we will see you next time.
Yes, sir.
Peace out, bro.
Peace out.